In part one, we saw how to set up a GS4 drive to read and write parameters via Modbus RTU. In this video, we'll learn how to command the drive to run, stop, and change frequency using the same Modbus pull application we used in part one. Before we do that though, it's really important to understand that the GS4 drive has two control paths, local and remote. So you can see which mode you're in here and switch between them by pressing these buttons, local, remote. You would typically set the local control mode to be the keypad, or maybe switches and potentiometers that are local to the drive. And you'd typically set the remote control mode to be Modbus RTU, Modbus TCP, Ethernet IP, etc., so you can control the drive remotely from another controller. Well, now that we know there's two control paths, all we have to do is tell each one what we want it to do. Run-stop is a binary on-off digital thing, so that's under the digital parameters menu, where we can set the remote or the local modes. In the remote mode, we can set the remote mode to be controlled locally by the keypad, locally by the drive's terminal strip for push-button control, with keypad stop enabled or disabled, RS-45 with the keypad stop enabled or disabled, or the optional COM card if we want to use Modbus TCP or Ethernet IP. Again, you can select whether you want the keypad stop enabled or disabled. We're doing Modbus RTU, so we want to control the drive via RS-45, and let's keep the keypad stop enabled so we can force the drive to stop from the keypad even if it's being controlled remotely. Parameter 3.1 is the same thing and has the exact same options, but it's for local control. Let's have the keypad be our local control. So we just set up the remote and local control for run-stop. Now let's do the same thing for controlling frequency. Frequency is an analog thing, so we go to the analog menu, and sure enough, there's a remote and local setting for the frequency control. We can set the frequency control to be from keypad, RS-45, the analog input, the drive's terminal strip, or the COM card for Modbus TCP or Ethernet IP. Let's set the remote frequency control to the same RS-45 that we used for the on-off control. Exit out of that, and then set the local frequency control to be from the keypad. Normally, if you press local, the drive will do whatever the local input tells it to do. And if you press remote, the drive will do whatever the remote command is telling it what to do. But you can modify the behavior of the transition between the two with parameter 3.58. We won't go into that here, I just wanted to make sure you are aware that you can specify how that transition between local and remote is made. Well, that's it. You just tell the drive that you want it to accept remote commands over the RS-45 channel. So if we bring up the Modbus Poll app that we used in a previous video, we should be able to control the drive. These are the parameters you need to change the frequency, run stop, and direction when using Modbus RTU. We see that parameter 926 is this decimal address. It's important to remember this table is showing the base address plus one convention for Modbus addresses. So a Modbus Poll, we need to tell it to use the plus one convention and then enter the 2331 address here. Modbus Poll adds the correct transaction type for us. And it looks like it's defaulting to a polling rate of 1 per second. That's fine for us. Let's label the fields to remind us what each one is. I'm still connected to the drive from the previous video, but if you aren't, then go ahead and do that now by going here. We see the packet count increasing at the 1 second rate we specified, and the frequency value here matches the frequency value on the display, so we know we're connected to the drive. Perfect. If you're not seeing that, then make sure the drive is set to accept remote commands by pressing the remote button. Double-click on the frequency and change it. We only want to write to the single frequency register, so hit send. Sure enough, the frequency is updated on the main display. We can also see that parameter 926 also got updated. Let's set the direction to reverse and tell the drive to run. And sure enough, the drive ramps up to speed. Let's issue a stop command. And sure enough, the drive ramps down to a stop. Now just for fun, let's put the drive in local mode and try to change the frequency. Look, we got an illegal data value and we also saw the red error light blink. I'll do that again so you can see the light blink. Those are both indicators that we did something wrong. Of course, in this case, we didn't have the drive in remote mode. So flip it back and now the command is accepted. Perfect. So in addition to the stuff we did in the first video, all we did was set the digital and analog controls to RS-45 and route to these registers to control the drive remotely. Click here to learn more about the GS4 drive. Click here to learn about Automation Direct's free support options, and click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.